The 19-year-old Swiss rider crashed during a qualifying session Saturday involving multiple riders. DePasquier lost control of his bike and went down among several riders and machines. The Guardian reports he was struck by another bike while on the pavement. MotoGP issued a statement following the tragedy, saying in part, DePasquier was involved in a multi-rider incident between turns 9 and 10 with the session red flag thereafter. FIM medical intervention vehicles arrived at the site immediately, and the Swiss rider was attended to on the track before being transferred by medical helicopter in a stable state to Careggi Hospital in Florence. Despite the best efforts of circuit medical staff and all those subsequently attending to the Swiss rider, the hospital has announced that DePasquier has sadly succumbed to his injuries.
Then the MotoGP race itself, the paddock assembled pre-race for a moment of silence. This, the Gran Premio d'Italia, run with somber hearts everywhere. The moment of silence honoring DePasquier, his team, his friends, riders standing side by side before the race and observing a 60-second moment of silence. And then drama on the race itself before lights out. Johann Zarco was rear-ended by this runaway bike by rookie Enea Bastianini. His race was over before it began. Early on in the race, six-time MotoGP champ Marc Marquez crashes out, and on the same lap, Pecco Bagnaia, in the lead, joins him, both looking on in disbelief. That was at the Arrabbiata 2. Takaki Nagakami was also a late crasher, as was Alex Rins. Crashes out as well, rotten luck all around, but in the end, the Bagnaia crash and Zarco's slow start put Fabio Quartararo in a lead, which he never relinquished. Little trouble for the Frenchman, who passed Zarco at the Poggio Secco, ended up winning by exactly 3 seconds. And then classy moments all around by he and his team, Quartararo's team, waving the Swiss flag as a tribute to DePasquier, and Quartararo stopping at the site of the crash and pointing toward the heavens, wiping tears from his eyes. Quartararo's wide margin also opens a wide margin over Zarco in the overall rider standing. Zarco down in fourth at the Mugello. Miguel Oliveira and reigning world champ Joan Mir complete the podium with Quartararo. It's Oliveira's first top 10 of the season. My favorite petrolhead, Ed Russell and Matteo Guerinoni, have more.
Round 6 of the MotoGP World Championship brought us to Mugello, a track where the Ducatis have dominated in the past 3 stagings. In 2021, though, it was a Yamaha who reigned supreme, the factory Yamaha of Fabio Quartararo. He said that he set his best ever lap in qualifying on Saturday, and arguably on Sunday, Matteo Guerinoni, that was one of his best ever performances.
Yes, absolutely. You know, he was very fast on a single lap. You know, doing in Mugello, 146 is already very fast, but 145.1 was absolutely extraordinary. He got the pace, and the setup of the bike was fantastic, and he's in a great form. He believed in himself so much. He was 4 times on the podium, and he got 3 victories. Do not forget that last time around in Jerez, he was in front, and he lost it because of arm pump, you know. So at the very end, he did a fantastic job this weekend, and he got back what belongs to him, you know. And even though Pecco unfortunately crashed, but even though Pecco was there to, you know, last Sunday in Mugello, was very difficult to beat this Quartararo.
Behind Fabio Quartararo, the battle for the remaining 2 spots on the podium was between Joan Mir and Miguel Oliveira. Miguel Oliveira had initially crossed the line second. He was then demoted a spot for exceeding track limits on the final lap before the same punishment came the way of Joan Mir, and it finished exactly how the two riders crossed the line. But that track limit issue, particularly here in Mugello, Matteo, has become pretty messy.
Not only in Mugello. You know, I would take off all the green area in all the tracks of MotoGP, because a long time ago there used to be grass over there, or white paint, you know. So at the very end, you just ride like an old rider, and then you have fun, you know. If you go on the grass and you have the attributes to keep the throttle open, it's good for you. Otherwise, it's too bad, you know. But to disqualify, like, or to not disqualify, but to punish a rider like Miguel Oliveira because out of The San Lorenzo, he was on the green spot, was absolutely unbelievable. Also because he didn't gain any advantage on that corner, but the rules are there, you know, so what else to say?
And I know rules are rules. I also know Fabio rules. Quartararo's doubled his career win total in just six races with four poles. He finished fifth in the World Championship 2 years ago, even without a win. Currently, Quartararo's favored to be crowned world champ at season's end, but Sunday's celebration was clouded by Saturday's tragedy.